Hey there, Pisces. Welcome to your reading for the middle of December 2020. We are going to jump right in here and take a look at your current energies with this main spread, and then we're going to clarify with for more detail any solutions and anything else that wants to come up with the baby tarot here. So Pisces, let's see what's going on for you. For a full picture of what could be going on for you for the rest of the month, make sure to watch your sun, moon, and rising. But Pisces, we got a lot of cards want to kind of pop out here. So I feel like it could be like, I feel like it's getting very active here. And here you go. You have the Knight of Wands. Just like I was saying, it's like all of a sudden, I feel that there could be a lot of activity, a lot of movement going on in your life, or you're making a lot of moves at this time, Pisces. So I love that. I feel like this is certainty, is what I would say to you. It's like you're very, I feel a very certain feeling. I don't know how else to describe it, Pisces, but it's like you're very, very sure of yourself at this time. And I definitely like to see that for you. Your overall energy is the building blocks card. Again, it's like on this card, it looks like these blocks are kind of falling into place, if you can see that. So I feel like things are kind of like falling into place, or, you know, things are just going really well for you at this time. So I really like that. I also feel like you are just very, very sure of yourself and this for the rest of this month. And I feel that could be leading to a lot of success for you as well, Pisces. You start off with the devil in your first row here. I do feel like some of you could be cutting someone out, especially if you have like someone spying on you with the page of swords here. So I feel for some of you that you're cutting someone out here. For others, I feel like you've dealt with a negative situation. It doesn't have to be love, Pisces, just something else that's toxic. It could be an addiction. It really feels like a person to me. So I feel for some of you, you've been dealing with someone who's been trying to bring you down. It feels very subtle. Like, you know, this could be like one of those things where it's someone that you thought was a friend. I feel like you would already, like, this is not a secret. This is not something that's hidden, Pisces. I feel like if this message is for you, you already know, who this person is. I feel like you already know, what's going on. So it's like, this is your past position. So I feel you already know who this person is, but I feel like you're just cutting this person out of your life. You have the High Priestess, the Four Pentacles. And then you have the Page of Swords with the Four of Wands down here. This is your energy with the High Priestess, so definitely coming up in a very strong position. There's like a lot of recognition and achievement for you this month, I feel. I feel for some of you, it's like you're, it's like in the past, you weren't really sure what path you wanted to take. You have this B and this J here on this High Priestess card. You know, some people look at it as like dark and light, or, you know, having a negative choice and a positive choice to make. It could just be a choice, any type of choice here. I feel that your intuition was clouded, that, you know, I feel that you felt very much bound to a person or to a situation here. You even have the Four of Pentacles, which is kind of very similar. The Four Pentacles could also say that you felt very stuck. You know, Four Pentacles is a card of holding on to tightly onto something that no longer serves you. So I feel, and that's not always true, but, you know, it can represent that. So I feel for some of you, this could have been you holding on to something. It could have been a marriage for some of you, the Four of Wands and Page of Swords, involving children with the Page of Swords. It could also just be that you were holding on to something that you knew was immature. Maybe you have been holding on to something that you knew couldn't develop. But I love that Four of Wands here for you, Pisces, because it's kind of like you're making the choice, or you have already made the choice that is going to lead to more freedom in your life here. So I really like to see that. Even in your middle row here, you have the Nine of Cups, which, you know, this person, this Nine of Cups in the Light Seer's Tarot, it's like this person looks like they're really, number one, joyful, and the Nine of Cups is definitely a card of choosing joy. It is a card that says you need to choose joy and happiness at this time, but it almost looks like they're, you know, they're glowing. They could be getting, you know, a lot of attention on this card. We could say that they're standing out as well. And you have the Six of Wands with the Magician. The Six of Wands is a card of attention. It's a card of victory, but he's receiving a lot of attention from the people that are kind of on the other side of this horse here, and he was victorious. The Magician is a card of manifestation. This is something that you worked for, I feel. You even have the Three of Pentacles here. It's almost like you are, this is a very simple reading. It's not almost like, it is a very simple reading. I feel you are getting attention for hard work that you have done with this Magician card. In this row here, you have the Six of Wands, Magician, Three of Pentacles, and the Two of Cups here. This could say that you are attracting a perfect match with the Two of Cups here. It's like someone rushing in to your life with this energy, someone that you are very passionate about with this Knight of Wands as well. It could be like an Aquarius. That's the only sign that stands out to me is air. So it could be someone who has air in their chart. Could be any sign, fire as well. And so it could be someone who has fire in their chart. Could even be a Capricorn. That Capricorn doesn't really stand out to me though. So I feel like it's probably air or someone with fire. I feel like those could be like major placements that this person has. So I feel like that'll be your clue. It's almost like they're not an air or fire sign. They could be, but it's almost like they just have like major placements in either air or fire. But I feel like it's someone who really wants to work on a team if you're looking for love. It's like this is something that you have attracted. I'm getting something about like leveling up here as well, Pisces, with that Six of Wands and this Magician. It's almost like maybe the type of person that you would date in the past, it's almost like that type of person no longer serves you. And I feel you could be kind of upgrading the type of person that you start dating or that you spend time with, if that makes sense. But I really feel like this is more about you getting attention again. Even Two of Cups to me is you and your higher self. To me, it says you are more listening to your higher self. You are doing things that your higher self wants you to do. So I feel like you're kind of more in alignment for the rest of this month as well. And you're probably feeling that more kind of aligned energy for you, Pisces. So I definitely really like to see this for you. Definitely getting recognition for the work you do as well. Next, you have the Six of Cups here. Definitely, you know, card of nostalgia, thinking about the past with the Six of Cups. I feel for some of you, you have the Knight of Wands, the Nine of Swords, and the Knight of Swords here. I do feel that this could be a choice between two people for some of you. You could be worrying about it with this Nine of Swords. For others, I feel that maybe you feel that in the past, you couldn't get the things that you desired with the Knight of Wands and this Nine of Swords. It's like there'd be something that you would desire to have in your life, but maybe it just never worked out. It's like I'm looking at the reading this way. You have the Knight of Wands, you have the Six of Wands, the Magician, and the High Priestess. It's like you took action on things that you desired to have in your life, and maybe you'd get some success, but then things would kind of stall out. But if we go this way, Knight of Swords, Two of Cups, the Four of Wands, and the Page of Swords, like this is a much better energy. I feel like you are stepping into this Knight of the positive side of the Knight of Swords energy. To me, the Knight of Swords is like rushing, doing things too quickly. But if we were to look at that as a positive, we could say that he does move quickly. But if he were to embrace his positive traits, if he were to step into this positive side of his energy, he would think before he did things. He would follow here his curiosity with this Page of Swords, but he would also do his research. He would double check everything that he's doing. So if you're like starting anything new, starting a business, starting a relationship, I would just double check everything you do with this energy. I feel like that will lead to success for you, Pisces. But I really like the direction of this reading so far. Again, I feel this is going to be like a very active time for you the rest of December. So let's see what we have for you, Pisces. Pisces, between the High Priestess, the Magician here, and this Six of Wands, you have the Tower. Yeah, like I said, I feel like there was some sort of ending in a situation. I feel the timing just wasn't right for a lot of you if you've gone through an ending or like the timing was off. So I don't really look at this as like an ex coming back or anything, Pisces, but this whole reading, even though you have the Six of Cups here, I do feel for some of you, it's like there could still be desire with a person from the past. But, you know, to me, this says that there was probably like a Tower moment, probably because the timing wasn't right. I really feel like this Nine of Cups is saying that the time is right. It's like you have the tools with the Magician. I feel that maybe in the past you would start a project or a business or whatever. It's like you just didn't have the right tools. Now I feel like you do. And not having the right tools caused the Tower is probably what happened. For others, I feel like these repetitive Tower moments that you've gone through, because you've probably gone through a bunch, Pisces, over like the past 8 years, because it's like an 8 year cycle for Pisces with Uranus was in Aries. And so you've probably built up a very, very solid foundation, which is what I feel this reading is saying. I feel like it's saying, yeah, you've had a lot of Tower moments, but these Tower moments have pretty much made you an expert with a ton of different tools that you now have at your disposal. So I love this. This is amazing. Between the Four of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles, you have the Nine of Pentacles. Nine of Pentacles, card of gratitude and luxuries, but she kind of has everything she needs. So again, I feel that this is one of those kind of like independence readings, Pisces, where it's like you finally have everything that you need at your disposal. Between the Page of Swords here, the Four of Wands, and the Two of Cups, you have the Page of Swords. As I always say, when I get a repeating card like this, to me, it's like the universe just saying, I meant what I said. So I feel like this is just the universe confirming that Page of Swords. I feel like it's saying you need to be curious about things and do your research about anything that you're considering starting. Could be love, could be business, could be anything. I feel like saying like there's nothing wrong with taking a pause. You know, while I feel like this ending here, we're going to pull a clarification row here, Pisces, but I feel like this ending is saying that things are about to speed up for you. Like not only this month, but I feel like in 2021, you could be starting to see more progress or more speed is what I feel here. More reasons to take action on things that you want to do. But at the same time, I feel like this is saying like you're going to be moving very quickly. There's no reason to rush, you know, like take your time, do your research on things that you're studying. Between the Magician here and the Knight of Wands, you have the Justice card, balance, things balancing out. I feel like you're learning how to play the game here, Pisces. Justice is cause and effect. It's like, you know, how do you get this scale on the Justice card to tilt in your favor? And the Justice card just says that with this Magician, you have probably learned the actions that you need to take to get the scale to tilt in your favor. This is very positive. I feel like this is a good thing. I don't even think this is a, you know, it could be a legal situation for some of you, but really, I feel like it's just what you have learned. You have learned how to take action. You have learned like the things that you need to do that get the scales tilting in your favor. Between the Three of Pentacles and Nine of Swords, you have the Seven of Swords here. I definitely feel for some of you, if there was a lying, cheating, stealing situation, you could be definitely getting justice in that situation here. For others, I feel like this is saying more that it's like you can't know the future. I feel like I said this to you like a couple weeks ago in one of the weekly readings, Pisces. The Seven of Swords kind of says like you can't prevent things from happening. You cannot prevent future tower moments. But what we can do is we can take those tower moments as learning lessons. We can try to find the positive in tower moments, or we can make sure we learn from tower moments. It's like we can't prevent things from happening in our lives. Things will always happen. You know, there will always be hiccups, road bumps, speed bumps, mountains, whatever you want to call it, right? These things will always happen. But, you know, what we can control is how we respond to these things. I do feel like you are getting better at responding to, you know, challenges is what this reading is saying. Between the Two of Cups and the Knight of Swords, you have the Ten of Cups, fortune after difficulty. A lot of happiness coming in for you, I see here. I feel like you're rushing towards someone that you could have a family with. Ten of Cups is happy home, happy family. So this could be you moving towards someone where you're going to have it all. For others, I feel like it's just fortune after difficulty. I feel like it's just improvements. Top row, you have the Ace of Swords, definitely a victory coming in for you. Again, if you are dealing with something legal, this is a legal victory. It's funny that I said that you are going to be able to conquer future challenges with this Seven of Swords. If we go this way, it's like Page of Swords, Seven of Swords to the Ace of Swords. And so, like I said, Ace of Swords, the sword is above the mountain on this card. And it just represents the fact that you now can very easily overcome future obstacles. Just like I was saying, it's like you have learned how to, maybe you know you can't avoid certain things from happening, but you can control the outcome by how you react. And that's what you're learning. In your middle row here, you have the Six of Cups again. So definitely some of you could be thinking about the past. For some of you, I do feel like there's like a little bit of, I would be careful of nostalgia. Six of Cups twice in this reading. Like I would be careful of getting too stuck in the past. I would be careful of like thinking too much about, you know, things that you're missing out on or you feel like you're missing out on from the past. Because I feel like things are looking up, but sometimes I think we can say, my life doesn't look exactly how I want it to look. So you can maybe get a little disappointed about that here. I feel like this is saying things look really good for you this month. So don't jump to the negative. Bottom row outcome, Four of Wands. So marriage, you have the Four of Wands twice as well, Pisces. I just did a reading like this for you like a couple weeks ago where you had a bunch of repeating cards. I feel like a lot of you could be meeting someone that you will marry. I feel like there have been probably a lot of disasters for you in love here. The Three of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, it's like you have had to learn maybe like warning signs. Maybe you've had to learn how to work together with people, but it's like now I feel like you're rushing towards true love. The Two of Cups, Ten of Cups, Knight of Swords, rushing, Four of Wands, marriage. So I feel for some of you, it's like you're charging towards someone that you could have a family with. For others, this is just freedom. I feel like you're being set free and your life is probably about to be more free simply because you have the tools necessary to create this freedom. This could be financial freedom, but it doesn't have to be. It could be any other type of freedom that you desire. And it's like you have the tools necessary. I really like this reading for you. Very like empowering as well, Pisces. So love it. So thank you for watching. Make sure to check out your sun, moon, and rising again. And also I will see you next month for the January reading.